The seed's greatest potential is when it's put in the ground. To get the perfect seedbed going, there are a few things we need to consider. Let's look at it with the seed in focus. Let's focus on the seed and start with the seedbed. If we start on the ground below the seed, our most important part is to get the moisture going for the seed, because that needs to swell up. We also need to think, though, a little bit afterwards. So to get that moisture going, we need a consolidation, but not too much, because afterwards the roots want to penetrate the soil, and therefore we need some pores in the soil. Let's look above the seed. So here we have the moisture below. Now we need to stop this moisture from evaporating into the air. Therefore, we make a so-called evaporation barrier. The evaporation barrier is a layer of fine tilth. This fine tilth also helps us to increase the temperature around the seed. The temperature is very crucial to get a fast germination. When we have air in this horizon, it also helps us for the seed to respire. Because once the seed has swelled and started to germinate, the processes within the seed is starting and it needs oxygen and it needs to release carbon dioxide. So therefore this layer has to contain air. Looking at the field surface, we need to be aware there are some things we cannot control, and that's the weather. We need to make a field surface that is weatherproof. We do this by sorting a little bit bigger soil fractions to the top. They can take up the energy of heavy rains. So that way we prevent crusting of the surface and make the best conditions possible for the germinating seed. So when we start to see this together, we see it's quite a complex matter. And we need to look at the three different horizons together to make the perfect conditions for the seed. A perfect seedbed gives a good start for your crop and maximizes your yield potential. Here, it's worth to place your focus.